by the journalist team. In main stories we have, millions of low-income households could see a power bill cut after a watchdog's report into the UK's energy sector. Flood warnings remain after downpours in central England. And South African kidnapper of baby Stephanie nurse guilty. Now over to Caleb with the main stories and one about the Islamic State.
In the main stories today, a leak of so-called Islamic State militants' information has wiped the secrecy of 22,000 terrorists. Thousands of documents detailing phone numbers and family contacts are handed to news agencies by a disillusioned convert to the group. I personally believe that Daesh is a terrorist group who use their religion as an excuse to wreak terror and destruction across the world, specifically Iraq and Syria. Our main story today is smoking, but first, here is Abby with her story. Abby?
Thank you, Caleb. Hello, I'm Abby reporting for Dinninton High School. You might remember in 2010, a killer whale killed its trainer, Dawn Brancho. This whale, thought to be 35 years old, is dying of a lung infection. It is being well cared for at SeaWorld, but it is not responding to the treatment. Tillick was captured in 1983 off the coast of Iceland, from where he was taken to SeaLand in Vancouver. He was responsible for the death of another person, which is why he was moved to SeaWorld, Orlando. SeaWorld and SeaLand are not related. Now for Caleb's story. Over to you, Caleb.
Thanks, Matthew Patrick was born with congenital kidney problems, is on dialysis and he takes 18 tablets a day to stay alive. Matthew's mother says a kidney transplant will change his life. The mother of the 10-year-old boy, who has been on the waiting list for a kidney transplant for 9 years, is appealing for people to join the NHS organ donor register. Matthew Patrick, from Leicestershire, was born with a CO problem, which stopped his kidneys working properly. His mother Nicola gave him one of hers when he was a year old, but it had to be removed because of complications 2 days later. Now, the little boy, who has neither of his kidneys, is on dialysis and it takes 18 tablets a day just to stay alive. Mrs. Patrick says that his life at the moment is so much about medicines and machines, diet restrictions and fluid restrictions. Unfortunately, he can't play what he loves, football, due to his tragic illness. He needs a kidney transplant, which he hasn't had for 9 years. Tragically, Matthew is not alone, and there are currently 65 children on the UK transplant waiting list for a kidney. Now, Abby's second story.
In April 2015, Hatton Garden heist occurred. The heist was planned and carried out by four elderly men who were experienced thieves. It was the largest burglary in English legal history. Over £14 million worth of jewels were stolen from 73 of the 1,000 safety deposit boxes. Two-thirds of the loot is still missing. Now, for John's story. Over to you, John.
Thank you, Abby. Now for the top 10 singles of this week. Now at number 10, Light It Up by Major Lazer, featuring Nyla and Fuse ODG. Personally, I like this song because it's got a lot of Afro-Caribbean stereotypes in it, which is really good. Musical stereotypes in it, which is really good. At number 9, it's Love Yourself by Justin Bieber. At number 8, When We Were Young by Adele. Well, this is a normal classic song by Adele, all about how she's feeling about some boy that she met when she was younger. And it's quite depressing. At number 7, Fast Car, Jonas Blue, featuring Dakota. At number 6, Girls Like by Tiny Temper, featuring Zara Larsson. I really like this song because it's really cool and it makes you want to break out in street dance. Number 5, Here For A Weekend. I actually haven't heard this song, but it sounds like a really good song. Especially if it's made by Coldplay. Number 4, Work by Rihanna, featuring Drake. I really hate this song because it's a earworm that makes you sing work, 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 work constantly throughout the day. Number 3, Lush Life by Zara Larsson. I really like this song because it reminds you of those summer days in this damp, cold weather. Anyway, number 2, I Took a Pill in Ibiza, CB Remix, Mike Posner. actually haven't heard this song, and the title really worries me because it said, I took a bill in Ibiza. I need to say no more. Number one, 7 Years by Luke Graham. I really like this song because it reminds you about, it tells you about the journey of a boy's life and how it develops from being a boy into a man. Now, for Caleb and Daniel.
We know that the earlier children become addicted to tobacco, the more likely they are to die in middle age, taking around 15 years from their life expectancy. What is striking about this survey is the ease in which young people can feed their deadly habit. For instance, 1 in 5 children can buy cigarettes from vending machines. More than 8 out of 10 are buying cigarettes from their peers in school. And more than 1 in 10 can buy tobacco from ice cream vans, burger vans and private dwellings. Most concerning of all is that children are consuming an average of 45 cigarettes per week, and in some cases up to 200 cigarettes per week. The level of spending on cigarettes is certain to cause them long-term damage to both the child's health and their bank balance. The survey of more than 100 underage smokers in South Wales, Valleys and Cardiff also revealed that 13% may be buying illegal or smuggled cigarettes. The latest figures from 2006 suggest that 23 of 15-year-old girls and 12% of boys smoke regularly.
A researcher said that this would suggest that children are accessing tobacco from criminal sources. We do not want Welsh children involved in such activity, even if they are ignorant to the problem and issues that surround it, he said. The sale of single cigarettes in the UK was outlawed in 1991 because of their appeal to young people, but 7% of those surveyed claim to have purchased single sticks in either shops or mobile burger and ice cream vans, while up to 80% have access to single cigarettes from friends and family. This is scandalous, and we need to do all we can at national and local level to stamp this problem out.
Thank you for watching BBC School Report.
This has been Dinninton High School Journalist Club.
Goodbye.